I am very happy to meet you in this video class. I hope everyone is fine and being safe at home. In this semester, I handle your History of English Literature 2. Now, let us begin from Unit 3, that is Victorian Age. Here, I would like to say about the objectives of today's class. First one is Victorian Age. Second one is Recollection of Romantic Age. Third one is General Characteristics of Victorian Age. Fourth one, Important Journal of this Period. And fifth one is Important Writer of this Age. These are the objectives we discuss in this class. Now, let us briefly discuss the objectives one by one. First one is Victorian Age, that is from 1837 to 1901. Do you know why do we call this age as Victorian Age? Now, I share the answer with you. In the history of England, Queen Victoria ruled the country from 1837 to 1901. Name Victorian Age, and the literature produced during Victorian literature. Next, we move on to the next objective, that is Recollection of Romantic Age. That means from 1770 to mid of 19th century. Here, you may have the question that why do we want to recollect some points regarding Romantic Age. Now, I give reason for this. In the history of English literature, Victorian Age is next to Romantic Age. So, we must have some prior knowledge on Romantic Age. Romantic Age is a dominant movement in history of English literature. Particularly, they show development in arts, music and painting, celebration of countryside, gives much importance to nature. In general, we can say that Romantic writers' subject matter is self-expression, individual feelings, imagination, etc. They explore the truth of the imagination rather than the scientific truth. That means they did not focus social values or scientific values in their writings. Next objective is Important Writer of this Age. Can you say some important writer's name? Now I give. First one is William Wordsworth, S.T. Coleridge, Robert Southey, Jane Austen. Let us get into the next topic now, that is General Characteristics of Victorian Age. During Victorian Age, there was a gap between rich and the poor people. So, the country made many social and historical changes. The gap between rich and the poor people created so many cultural values in the society. That means there were some issues between rich and the poor people. Now, we discuss about the changes that the people came across during Victorian Age. First one is Industrial Revolution. Then, what is Industrial Revolution? It's a transition to new manufacturing process in Europe and the United States in the period about 1762, sometime between 1820 and 1840. This transition includes the following. First one is from handmade production method to machine. Next one is textiles were the dominant industry of the Industrial Revolution. Third one is many technological innovations were introduced. In general, we can say that the Industrial Revolution marks a major turning point in the history of England. Next changes, development in the trade during this period. During this period, England emerged as the most powerful trading nation in the world. One of the partners of England is China because of the fine silk production. There were also many other trading partners in the Victorian era. England saw that they could really benefit by working with other countries. Next, they passed the Reform Bill of 1832 by Lord Grey. Then, who is Lord Grey? Prime Minister of England, who ruled the country that time. Now, I would like to give answer for the question, what is the Reform Bill of 1832? It is an act of Parliament of United Kingdom. This bill helped the nation to become stronger by abolishing small district and gave representation to the cities. That means they focused on the development of cities. Next one is position of women in the Victorian era. The roles of women was mostly that of being angels of the house and restricted to domestic confines. That means Victorians believed that a woman's proper and only place was to be within a household environment. The women were expected to marry, have children, and keep a nice household. Those were the only acceptable roles for women during that era. Next, there was a good development in scientific progress. The progress of science kept pace with the progress of democracy. Soon, electricity, heating, lights and gas were supplied to the citizens of London. Especially, they invented safety bicycle, electricity, light bulbs and photography, etc. Next one is about development of education in the Victorian era. In early period of Victorian age, there were very few schools available for girls. But wealthy girls were mostly educated at home. Later, their attitude towards children's education changed dramatically. Both boys and girls were able to go to school. The improvement in the education was reflected in many ways. Because of the development in the education, they were available with many newspapers, magazines, and textbooks, etc. The development of education gave payment to the development of literature also. Next, we discuss about the important journal of this period. The important journals of this period are poetry and novels. Victorian poetess were the conflicts between scientific discoverers. The Victorian poetess have the following qualities. The poetess of Victorian are more light-hearted and humorous, whimsical or nonsensical, and much realistic. What is the meaning for whimsical? That means the poetry of Victorian are more fanciful. The subject matter of Victorian poets were social-oriented. They did not have about love and worship of nature as romantic poets had in their poetry. So, the subject matter of Victorian writer is social-oriented. Dealing with the poetry, the poetries of Alfred Lord Tennyson and Robert Browning played a vital role in this age. So, the Victorian age is also called as the Age of Tennyson. In overall, we can say that Victorian age is a written from solitude to society, from nature to industry, from concept to issues, from spiritualism to pragmatism, and from organism to compromise. In the end of Victorian age, England became an urban and industrialized country in the world. In the next class, we see about the other important writer of this age.